In Scribus, like in InDesign, you can work in both RGB and CMYK. I use Scribus primarily for print, so the CMYK color space for me is important. In the last lecture, we activated color management. Let's do this again, and see what happens to the color swatches at the right. I go to File, Document Setup, Color Management. I activate color management. We see that all RGB swatches at the left have gotten an exclamation mark in the swatches panel. The exclamation mark indicates that the color cannot be printed. Because I use Scribus for print, I would like to have only color swatches that can be printed. And this is very easy to do. I will delete the CMYK colors. I go to Edit, Colors and Fills. I click on Remove Unused. I am left with unprintable RGB colors. We can see a color is RGB because of the icon showing red, green, and blue vertical stripes. When a color is CMYK, the icon shows four squares, representing cyan, magenta, yellow and black. When I hold my mouse above an RGB color, I can see the RGB values. And a CMYK color will show its CMYK values. I open the green RGB color by double-clicking on it. Now I can change the color. I can compare the result below old and new. Let's see if I can remove the exclamation mark for my new color. As we can see, it is quite difficult to do it this way, because the exclamation mark keeps on popping up again. So I click on Cancel, and open green again. As you may have guessed, the only way to work with printable CMYK colors is by entering the CMYK color space. So below color model, I simply switch from RGB to CMYK. This is the maximum vibrancy we can print green. And the changes that I make by dragging the sliders will never lead to an unprintable color. So when I create a new color, I will always use the CMYK color model. This way, I will never end up with an unprintable color. In the next lecture, we will look at how to convert RGB images to CMYK.